Last year, the Vatican received over 500,000 reports of demonic possession.
It knows you. It knows all your sins.
I haven't prayed in years. But last night, I found myself praying for you.
We're always looking for proof. Question is, what on earth would we do if we found it?
It's all based in reality, and it's based on a journalistic piece of work, the book The Rite by Matt Olio.
The Rite is about a young man who joins the seminary, and he's assigned to exorcism school.
This man's jaw spontaneously dislocated while being read the Lord's Prayer.
He's unconvinced at what he finds at the start in the college.
He has to face doubts about religion, faith in God, in evil.
Do you believe in sin?
Yes, I just don't believe the devil makes us do it.
He has a lot to offer the church.
In nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti.
But his own doubts have to be dealt with.
What do you think of the course so far?
To be honest, I don't know what to make of it.
So Father Xavier sends him to see Father Lucas.
Father Lucas lives in the outskirts of Rome, not in the fancy parts, and he's looked upon with suspicion from many people.
Buongiorno. I've never played a priest before. I've never played an exorcist before. And he's basically a very good man.
He's done over 1,000 exorcisms. He's very eccentric, really strong personality.
Don't like cats?
Not particularly.
Welcome to Rome. It's infested with cats. Make sure they don't come in. It's been the most enjoyable part I've had on the phone since Silence of the Lambs.
This is not your typical priest.
Anthony!
This is somebody whose job is to confront evil daily.
I'm a journalist. I would love to know what you saw today.
So you're asking me to spy?
No, I'm asking you to report your own experiences. She has an agenda, she knows what she wants, and this whole journey to this dark side brings them together. I'm just interested in the truth. Seems like you are too.
It is a sort of debate that takes place in the film. Is it the devil? Or is it psychology?
Does a thief or a burglar turn on the lights when he's robbing your house? No. He prefers you to believe that he's not there, like the devil.
It gets complicated when no proof of the devil is somehow proof of the devil.
Their questions have been around for hundreds of thousands of years.
He's treating a pregnant girl that I believe needs psychiatric care.
Father Lucas has been doing this longer than anyone I know.
Choosing not to believe in the devil won't protect you from him.
He also has his moments of crisis, faith crisis.
Michael, what's happening to me?
And that passes him on into the unorthodox, dark side of demonic possession.
Father?
I'm afraid he's out.
The character played is really possessed and is quite insane.
God is not here, priest.
And Michael, he has to confront Father Lucas.
Manifestation of the devil.
Your name! Give me your name!
If Lucas couldn't defeat it, how can I?
Michael!
Terrifying things begin to happen.
The terror is real, Michael.
The questions that he raises to himself are the type of questions that we all, at some point in our lives, have brought up.
Maybe there's a chance that the devil is real.
He's a deceiver.
Manifestation of sheer evil.